Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Innal hamdalillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa na'udzu billahi min syururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Asyhadu an la ilaha illallah wa asyhadu anna Muhammad abduhu wa rasuluh. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in, amma ba'd. Ismi ni Nabilah Najwa binti Osman Khairi wa sadiqati Syarifah Nurul Aina binti Said Abdullah. Wa nahnu min al-majmu'ah al-thalithah. Insya-Allah uridu an ashrah lakum an al-madah sirah Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam tahta al-mawdu' Hisar Bani Hashim wa sabaruhum ala mihna ad-da'wah. Okay. Al-an uridu an ashrah lakum at-ta'rif an Bani Hashim. Ma huwa at-ta'rif an Bani Hashim? Bani Hashim هو عشيرة مشهورة من قبيلة قريش قبل الإسلام وبعده في مكة وتنسب إلى هاشم يعني عمرو بن عبد مناف وبعد ذلك وبني هاشم هو أسرة عربية نشأت من مجموعة متحالفة من القبائل القوية المرابطة التي حكم منطقة الحجاز في السعودية على الامتداد ساحل البحر الأحمر. Okay, Bani Hashim is a famous clan of the Quraysh before and after Islam in Mecca. And it is attributed to Hashim, yakni Amru bin Abdul Manaf. Okay, actually, Hashim is the nickname of Amru. Okay. Wabil-idhafatu ila dhali, Hashim huwa al-jaddu thani li Rasulillahi alaih salatu wassalam. Wa ilayhi yantasibu al-Hashimiyuna ويعتبر أول من شرع الرحلتين الشهيرتين للقرش وهما رحلة الشتاء والصيف اللتين جاء ذكرها في القرآن الكريم كما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إيلافهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف صدق الله العظيم. Summa laqabihi wa kunyatuhu. Okay. Wahuwa ismun Hashim Amru bin Abdul Manaf. Wa antusambiyatuhu bihashim. Kanat lihashmuhu maqadir minal khubz. Wa at'am qawmuhu al-tharid bibakkah. Walladhi haddasa fi sana al-muja'ah. Zalika an qawmuhu min Quraysh asabihim qahtun. Farahla ila Filistin. فاشترى الدقيق فقدم به مكة فأمر به فقبز له ثم نحر جزوره ثم اتخذ لقومه من مرقه سريدا لذلك الخبز ويكني هاشم أيضا بأبي نضلة وأبا يزيد وقال بعضهم بل كان بأبنه أسد. Okay, his name Hashim was given to him because he helped many people. He helped feeding his people in Bakka. Okay, so this happened because his people from the Quraysh were hit by a drought. So he traveled. So he helped his people by travel to Palestine, and he bought food from there and brought it to Mecca for his people. Summa nasabuhu huwa Hashim bin Abdul Manaf bin Qusay bin Kilab bin Murrah bin Ka'b bin Lu'ay bin Ghalib ibn Fah bin Malik wa ghayruha. Okay. Al-muttasil nasabuhu ila Ismail bin Ibrahim al-Khalil alaihi salam wa ummuhu Atikah binti Marrah. Kana Hashim akbar waladu Abdul Manaf. Okay. Wahuwa a'zam Quraysh fil hisab wal nasab wa mukarram al akhlaq. Wa ba'da dhalik da'wah Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam liqaumihi jahriyah. Okay. كانت الدعوة في البداية سرية لمدة ثلاثة أعوام حتى أمر الله سبحانه وتعالى نبيه بالانتقال من الدعوة السرية إلى جهرية. فقال الله سبحانه وتعالى: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، فاصدع بما تؤمر وأعرض عن المشركين. صدق الله العظيم. وهذا هو سبب جهر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بالدعوة، فجهر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأصحابه بالدعوة. وأوضح للمشركين ما هم فيه من الجهل والضلال، ثم دعاهم إلى معونته ودعمه لمتابعة ما أمر الله سبحانه وتعالى به. ثم طلب منهم الاستجابة لداع الله والإيمان به. وأخيرا جعل مقر الدعوة بيت زعيم العشيرة أبي طالب، ليسمح للجميع بالحضور دون أن يترك أي عذر لأحد. وبعد ذلك أولا آندوا ورفضوا دعوته جهلا وتكبرا منهم، ولكن نبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ثبت واستمر على دعوته بعرض الحجة والدليل. ثانيا فلما رأوا الأعجاز من أنفسهم على مواجهته ورد الحجة بالحجة، بدأوا بالتضييق على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وصحابته وإيذاؤهم، وبخاصة الضعفاء منهم والذين لا ظهر لهم يحميهم. فتعرض العديد منهم التعذيب والسب وشتم والإيذاء. ثم فانتهجت معاداة رسالة الإسلام من خلال نشر ادعاءات الباطلة عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم والقرآن الكريم والصحابة السابقين إلى الإسلام. فقالوا أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنه ساحر ومجنون وشاعر، وهذا النهج من العداوة تعرضت له جميع الرسالة السابقة قبل الإسلام. وقد رد القرآن على جميع هذه الأقاويل والإدعاءات الباطلة. It means they said our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he was a magician, that he is crazy and everything bad about him. So they just don't want our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to do the da'wah. Okay. فهذا كل شيء، فهذا فقط مني، أسف جدا على خطائي، شكرا على استماعكم واهتمامكم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So my name is Sharifa Nuraina binti Syed Abdullah. Previously my friend have give some a little bit about ta'rif of Banu Hashim, the background, and how did Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam face the rebellions of Quraysh, and how did Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam give da'wah. So right now I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about the boycott of Banu Hashim. So firstly, as we know, the situation have changed right after Sayyidina Umar and Sayyidina Hamzah have embraced Islam. So we know that when they convert to Islam, the Islam itself have become more strong than before. So we know that because of this, Muslim able to pray clearly in the crowd. So this obviously makes the kuffar of Quraysh triggered and angry about this, because Islam have spread to different tribes. So we know that the Quraysh realized that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam have become strong because he always getting help from Banu Hashim. So we know that Banu Hashim is always stay beside Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we know that because of this, Quraysh thinks that we need to get rid Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by hook or by crook. So right now we move to the next slide. I'm gonna tell you guys what types of boycott that they did to Banu Hashim. So Quraysh agree together, they gathered together and they discussed to write a pact with regards to Banu Hashim and Banu Muttalib to not do this and to not do that. So they also agree that they will not deal with them kindly at all. So we know that Quraysh will not deal with Banu Hashim and Banu Muttalib kindly. They will act brutally towards them. So until they give Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Quraysh for them to kill him. So we know right here that Quraysh is never been good to them until they give Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam for them to kill him. Even though I list them four in the slide, but actually, in short, we can say that everything that involves Banu Hashim is prohibited. That means that if we want to interact with them, it's not, we cannot do that. So that means Quraysh cannot even deal with them, cannot sell anything to Banu Hashim, cannot interact with them, cannot get married to one of them, and even cannot talk to them. So that means they have been outcast. If we see to ourselves nowadays, if I were at school, if my friends outcast me or have boycott me, so obviously I will feel sad. But if we see to this event, we can see that Banu Hashim is really patient with everything. So the Quraysh have wrote the pact on some parchment and hung them inside the Kaabah, so everyone can read it. Okay, and then they forced Prophet and those who with him to flee to the valley of Abu Talib and confined, that was confined by Quraysh. So for your information, this boycott happens for 3 years. Can you even imagine for 3 years you have been boycott from anything? So that's mean that if we can think with our brain, for one day if we have been boycott, it must be really 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 depressed. So but they can cope with it. So I don't know what to say anymore. Hashim patiently wait and remain confined and tightly surrounded, very restricted, and not even being able to obtain any essential things from Quraysh for a period of 3 years. Oh, that was really really unthinkable about it. But so yeah, since Prophet was tribe of Banu Hashim, all of the kuffars of Quraysh combined together and led on a boycott. So every person who belonged to the family of Banu Hashim was included in the boycott. whether he or she is a Muslim or not. So that's mean that everyone who is part of family of Banu Hashim was included in this boycott. So Quraysh demanded that Banu Hashim hand over Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or at least relieve him of the protection of the tribe. But the tribal system in those days believe in the appointment of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They believe that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam always protect a person of their tribe at all costs. So this is the main reason why the Banu Hashim stood with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whether he is whether they believe or not that he is a prophet, but they still stand with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and underwent the boycott of the Quraysh. So if we can see nowadays, we can easily get access to everything, to food, to get clothes, to get what do we call cars. We can get facilities, we can get friends, we can get everything, almost everything we can get. But the ibrah here is that the lesson that we can get is, we can see the Banu Hashim is really patient and have faith in Allah, that they believe that the hereafter is much better and forever than this dunya. So like how that Allah has said in the Quran, Surah Al-A'la ayah 17, a'udzu billahi minash shaytanir rajim wal akhiratu khairun wa abqa. That's mean that hereafter is much better and forever. What do we need to do is, we cannot ever quit ourselves from this dunya, or we cannot even think to cut off ourselves from this dunya. That's mean that we cannot think to do commit suicide or something like that, because we know the most important thing in life is we need to have faith. Even we have the tiniest faith in our heart, that was the key to Jannah. So we cannot even think to commit suicide. We just need to be patient of everything in this life. We need to believe that Allah is always help us, Allah is always stand with us. So we need to be more grateful, because we can get easily access to everything, almost everything. But they have been patiently wait for a period of 3 years. So can we even imagine about that? So we need to be grateful and just be patient of everything. That is the most important thing in life, and just believe, because we need to have faith in Allah, because that is the key to Jannah. So that's all from me, and I hope that all of you can get some input, some what do we call benefits from what have we talked today. So that's all from me and my friends. I hope you guys enjoy, and I'm sorry for my broken English, but yeah, that's all for me. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Syukran.